Apsi, tra l'altro, pua muo, turuk.
Che mi fu pengau, mi srai pengaya!
Avatar fans won't have to wait until the film's sequel to revisit the alien world of Pandora. I was just focusing, paying attention there. Cirque du Soleil has created an acrobatic show inspired by the movie. It's called Turek and opens next month. CBC's Yelena Adzik is here with more. So how different is the show from the movie?
I know, it does require all of your attention, your focus. What is happening there? Okay, so we know that Avatar, the movie, right? This is the highest grossing movie that we have around the world, not just in North America, in this world. Exactly, Andrew. Okay, but in the world that you're watching here in the particular film Avatar, I want you to imagine that whether you've seen this film or not, the events that take place and the storytelling that takes place in the Cirque du Soleil show based on this Avatar, it's actually set thousands of years before the events depicted in the film that you're watching right now, and before any humans ever set foot on Pandora. Now, it happens to be the first time that they've ever had any English speaking, English dialogue, that is, in a Cirque show. We've never had that before. And we have a narrator, you saw a little bit of that off the top there, Andrew, where he speaks in the language Navi that we've come to know from James Cameron, of course, the director of the original blockbuster. And so there's a little bit of Navi there, but since most of us don't understand the made-up language of Navi, they also kind of translate for us in English. But what you also get is some puppetry and, of course, the stunts and the mastery, the body manipulation that you see in the dancers and the performers in regular Cirque shows. It just really does seem set to be quite phenomenal. And they're doing a bit of a soft opening, testing it out in various cities, and then they're having the big world premiere December 21st in Montreal. Now, we had a chance to catch up with some of the creators, some of the directors behind the show, and you know, the first question you thought of even, Andrew, is just, well, how much is it like Avatar? That's what we put to one of the creators. Have a listen to this.
I think if you want to see the movie again, you will not like the show. It's not the movie. And if you want to see a traditional Cirque du Soleil show, you will not like it. You have to be open to see something else, which is, yes, inspired by this movie, inspired by the world of magic of Cirque du Soleil, but in a new thing.
He's clearly not a PR man.
I love his candor.
You will not like it.
I love his candor.
It's awesome.
Cirque du Soleil is known, though, for its highly elaborate productions. Yeah. How much work does it take to pull something like this off?
Yeah, it's really massive. Now, they've had hundreds of people working on this for a very long time, of course, practicing and working on the stunts. But just to put this into perspective, Andrew, you know, Cirque is celebrating its 30th anniversary this year, right? And over that time, they have had more than 160 million spectators. And it's been in more than 400 cities around the world. They have more than 1,300 performing artists, and they're all from 50 different countries. I'm trying to establish how massive this production is, all of the various offshoots. As we know, there's many different types of Cirque shows. And it all just started from one man's imagination, Guy Laliberté, that's in Montreal. So it's phenomenal. And I think that at heart, there's a lot of heart, and that's really what audiences are drawn to, as well as the performers. Have a listen to this.
We don't know how people will react, but there's a lot of heart, there's a lot of love that's put in this show, and there's hundreds and hundreds of people that are working and believing in this dream, and we hope that that will touch people.
There you go. So the show is called Turek, First Flight, and it's all based on that incredible Avatar movie.
All right. Thanks very much, Yelena.
We'll see you soon, Andrew.